morning to all of you. Welcome to Engineers Career Group. I'm Sumit Kumar. We are presenting here GATE online crash course for GATE 2018. That's based on the subject, that is the strength of the material. That's equally important for the civil engineer as well as mechanical engineer. And having the weightage approximate 10 to 12 marks, and there are some major topics we are going to be introduced here one by one. First one is the basic concepts. In basic concept we are going to be cover assumptions and the strength and design criteria. In design criteria, first criteria is strength criteria, and second one is the rigidity criteria. In order to design a safe component or a structure, these both criteria are the important. If we are going to be designing any component, any machine element, if that particular component is going to be satisfy one criteria and is not satisfied, going to satisfy the second criteria, mean that this component is not going to be fully safe, mean that it may be failed because of the rigidity criteria. And that's why the both criteria is very important in order to design a safe component so that it can perform their functionality in a safe manner and a better manner. And second topic is loading diagram. In loading diagram there are four types of the diagram. First one is axial loading diagram, second one is shear force diagram, and third one is bending moment diagram, and fourth one is torque loading diagram. In axial loading diagram, the axial load diagram we are going to be draw for the horizontal reactions and action forces. In shear force diagram we are only representing the vertical reactions. And bending moment diagram, that bending moment is introduced because of the eccentric axial loading condition. If eccentric load is there, then bending moment will definitely come, and that bending moment is going to be draw in bending moment diagram. And fourth one is torque loading diagram. In torque loading diagram we are representing the torque. In third topic, that is the expression between the stress and strain. In stress and strain we are going to be cover four topic, and first topic is the bending stresses in beam, that exists because of the bending moment. And second one is the torsion in the circular shaft, and that torsion will come because of the torque, and that torque is introduced the shear stresses in the circular shaft. And that's a very important topic for the mechanical engineer, because mechanical engineer always looking for the power generation, power transmission from one place to another place, and that power transmission is going to be done by the help of the shaft. Shaft is the machine element that is going to be designed on the basis of the torsion in the circular shaft. And third topic is the shear stresses in beam. That topic is basically important for the civil engineer, because in every structure there are horizontal and vertical beams will be there, and those beams are subjected to the different loading condition. In order to calculate those particular loads in a different part, in order to judge the criticality of that particular structures and beam, that topic is very important. That is the third, shear stresses in beam. And fourth topic is thermal stresses. It comes because of the heat generation in the different surfaces between the different machine component relative motions, and those thermal stresses going to be modeled in that particular topic. And fourth topic is the principal stresses in beams. In principal stresses in beams, that is going to be modeled the stresses that going to be exist because of the combined loading condition. If combined load will be there, then combined stresses will come, and those combined stresses going to be transform in the form of the one expression, and that one expression in terms of the combined stresses, and that one expression containing the sigma x, sigma y and tau x y, those are the different stresses going to be exist in a different fields in a different planes. And those expression we are going to be utilized here in that particular topic. That topic is theory of failure. That's a very important topic in order to design a component, because in reality there is no failure stresses available for the combined loading condition. In order to complete those stresses, failure stresses, we are going to be present here five theory of failure. The first theory of failure is the maximum principal stresses theory, maximum principal stress theory, and second one is maximum shear stress theory, and third is maximum principal strain theory, and fourth one is the maximum strain energy theory, and fifth one is maximum distortion energy theory. Maximum the design software, they are based on the design on the basis of the different theory of failure, because every component that are in real engineering application that is subjected through the command loading problem, and that's why this theory of failure are very important. Sixth topic is that is the deflection of the beam. That's very important for the civil engineer as well as mechanical engineer. The here four major subtopic we are going to be cover. First one is the double integration method, how we are going to be develop a model and how we can utilize that model in order to calculate the deflection by analytical method, that is called double integration method. Second one is the moment area method. For the same purpose that the second method, how to calculate, sometimes very difficult calculation will exist in case of the double integration method. At that situation we are referred second method, that is called moment area method. And third one is that is Castigliano's method. Okay, this is the same method. If moment area method is not applicable somewhere, then we can utilize the Castigliano's method. It's a very important. And fourth one is the Maxwell theorem. That's also equally important in order to calculate the deflection for the beam for the different loading condition. And seventh topic is that is theory of columns and stacks. Here that mainly the column are classified into three form. First one is long column, short column, and third one is called medium column. There are some machine component they are treated like a medium column, and some of the component they are treated like a short column, and some of the component they are treated like a long column. In order to model that long column load, there are one model that is given by the Euler. That Euler theory is covered for the long column. And second one is the Rankine theory. That's equally applicable for the long column, short column, and medium column. We are going to be cover these theories in this particular topic, that is seven topic. And last topic is the thin pressure vessel. There are two types of the pressure vessels in general, that is cylindrical and spherical. You see the gun barrel and pressure cooker, they are the examples of the thin pressure vessel. They are always subjected through the pressures. Thank you so much for watching this video.
Subscribe to us now.